Hi, welcome to Drawing. I'm your instructor, Mark, and I'm going to be going over the supplies that we need for the class. Now, I don't have the specific supplies listed verbatim, but I want to go over some of the nuances and specifics of some of these things. The first thing on the list is your Bristol paper. The Bristol paper is 14 inches by 17 inches, and really, really important, it says Bristol on there. There's a couple different options. There is smooth and there's vellum. It doesn't matter, either one is fine. I prefer smooth, but make sure that you get Bristol paper, not any other type of paper. This Bristol paper is actually really kind of heavy duty. It's great for different material. So I want to make sure that you get this item specifically. Now this is the one that's actually listed, but the next pad of paper is going to be a little bit different. The next pad of paper that I want you to get is a 14 by 17 inch drawing pad. And this one's actually oversized. But the key thing here is that it says drawing. Some of the other options that you have available would be sketch or newsprint. Make sure that it's drawing. Now I want you to make sure that you get 14 by 17 for both of these pads. You can go bigger, but make sure that you do not go smaller because a lot of our projects are contingent on the scale of this paper. Next on the list are a bunch of different pencils, and they have some different designations. I don't have the Winsor & Newton ones. There's a couple different brands out there. What you want to pay attention to is the lettering on the brand. So this is a 6B, we've got a 2B, and an HB. Some other ones that you might be interested in is this extra black. This is a general extra black pencil. This is a graphite pencil, and it's different than, say, a normal number two pencil. The graphite is actually slightly different. Next on the list are some erasers, and in the carded eraser set, which I have listed there, you've got three different erasers. You'll get a white plastic or vinyl eraser, a gum eraser, and then a kneaded eraser, and it looks like this, but in a rectangle. You can buy those individually, or you can find that blister pack where it's all three together, and that's really cheap and inexpensive. Next thing on the list is a pack of brushes, and that pack of brushes that I have listed is a fantastic deal. It's $8 for, I think, 12 different brushes. They're basic quality, they're good enough for what we're going to be doing, and you have a wide variety of brushes. If you're looking at brushes individually or you have brushes of your own, we want to make sure that you're getting the short handle brushes, which are generally for watercolor, and that they're relatively soft and pliable. So you can see that this springs back into shape, but it feels very soft. It's not coarse, it's not like a bristle brush. These are synthetic. So they're synthetic brush. You don't have to spend too much money, but you want to make sure you don't get anything that like sort of explodes and splays out. So spend some money on the brushes or get that kit that I have suggested. Next on the list is a pack of charcoal pencils. If that is out of stock, individually the charcoal pencils would be a couple soft charcoal pencils and a couple medium pencils. So I think I have it listed 6B or medium, and then like, or 6B for dark, and 2B or 4B for medium. Don't get a hard charcoal pencil. So there is a difference between the charcoal pencils and the regular graphite pencils. So make sure that you're getting both of those. Also on the list is a white pencil. It doesn't have to be the specific brand. Any white charcoal pencil will work. Then we have some black ink, and actually, let me see if I have box. So I don't have the box for the black one. It comes in a bunch of different colors, but this is relatively inexpensive. It's about $3, so you can pick that up. Then we have a steel ruler. So this steel ruler has a cork back and it's stainless steel. Make sure that you get the stainless steel ruler because we'll be cutting up against it. And if it's aluminum, you might be able to cut through and that's a little bit dangerous. So the stainless steel ruler is the one that you want to get. Don't use a wood ruler. Don't use a plastic ruler. We're going to be using the stainless steel one. This one that I have here is in inches and centimeters. We'll just be using inches, so you can get that. Next on the list is a muffin tray. So this is just a plastic muffin tray. It's for mixing paint. You can use a styrofoam egg carton, anything that will hold liquid. You could even use multiple cups. We want it to be white because it makes it easier to understand what it is that we're looking at. So if you have a bunch of old mugs lying around, or you have like something like this, it needs to hold water. Then we have an X-Acto knife or a hobby knife. This is just a standard hobby knife. It's got a nice grip on it and it comes with a cap. Make sure that you're getting a hobby knife and not a box cutter. We need some dexterity to this. So you can see that I can hold this like a pencil and I can move it like a pencil. So go ahead and pick that up. I like the ones that have a cap on it, and I also like the ones that retract. So they retract and they're a little bit safer. You're gonna wanna get some extra blades for the knife and a pencil sharpener. I prefer to use a hand sharpener versus the one that you crank on or an electric sharpener. Just because I can control it, and with especially the graphite pencils are really kind of delicate. So putting it inside of a machine kind of lends itself to breaking it up and you gotta sharpen it even more. So this is really nice to have. This one has two different size holes. You can maybe see that, I don't know if it'll focus. But that way you can fit different size pencils in there. And then, at the bottom of the list, we also have some ballpoint pens. So just some standard ballpoint pens. Any color will do. If you have blue and black and that's all you got, that's fine. But if you can pick up some other different colors, then that's great too. There's some other things that we're gonna be using throughout the semester. We'll need a glue stick, magazine. It's all listed there. It should be pretty self-explanatory. If you have any of these supplies from other classes, you do not have to buy that specific for this class. So you can use and kind of be resourceful with what you have lying around. Everything that I have listed in the supply kit is required for this course, and I've made as many considerations as possible to cost and pricing. So there's a lot of options to go shopping at Michael's and Joann's. You might use the 40% off coupon there. But Dick Blick tends to have the best supply and it's really inexpensive. So look at Dick Blick first, see what you can pick up. But if you're shopping at other places, you're more than welcome to do that. In another video, I'm gonna talk about how to set up your studio space at home and get you started on trying to work. But this should get you out there looking for supplies and buying all your things. All right, see you soon.